I did a little bit of gardening for my dad. Cutting the suckers out, which are basically from the same tree, but growing from the ground. So they're sucking the soil. Essentially this lower tree is not growing properly, but anyways, that was a good little warm up. And then I got my new gear. I got a 7-pound Macebell from Onnit. I got a 25-pound quad Macebell from Onnit, and I'll show you that. And then I also got a short barbell, 5-foot-long barbell, which is really cool because, you know, a typical barbell, if like you're doing one-armed stuff, it's harder to balance. So it's gonna be really great. And it's also great for coaching people, for beginners, because you don't really need a 45 pounder all the time. I think it's like 25, 30 pounds. So I'm really stoked to implement that and just share with you some of the movements I did to warm up. I kind of went from 7 to 10 to 20 pound to 25 pound Macebells. Got them all right here. And then I'm gonna do my barbell work. And you know, just a lot of overhead kind of things, as well as just lower body kind of deadlift, and just supporting here, here, and at the side. So just that pulling strength, kind of vertically pushing strength, all that shifting weight, you know. So keeping a really good base. This is going to be the theme of my workout today. This is like the fruit of it. This is the juicy part where I get to play. So hope you guys enjoy. Let me just check this, see how the battery is, what's going on. So let's show you guys. Got all different lengths of things. Started off with this guy. And then basically doing the same movements throughout all the different weights, and just throwing in stuff that feels intuitive, listening to my body, being present with the motion, and some movements taking away, and then just focusing more on the movements that it's better to just focus on at a higher weight and difficulty, which is usually more basic. So yeah, I'll show you. So this this guy I also just got, he's pretty focused on being within, it seems, on all sides, on all faces of the illusion. So I'm just gonna go right into the barbell because I already did these other weights to progress. So yeah, enjoy this. Who's on here? What's going on?
Coming back here, yeah, back to you.
How we doing, guys? Who's on? I loaded the barbell uneven. I started off like this, and it's really good because it just challenges you to create torque within your own body. You know, we have these fascial lines, myofascia, connective tissue essentially, above all the muscles, all the joints, all the bones, and just right under the skin. It's like spider silk strength and flexibility, and just carries a lot of information, emotional memories stored within the body. It's really cool stuff if you look up myofascia. But anyways, there's these lines of the fascia that, you know, connect from like the base of your foot all the way up to like your neck, your skull, and just different networks that physiologists and physical therapists have studied. And it's basically really just If we look at not just the muscles and the bones, we look at the fascia, we can really understand how we can transmit force through the body and do these forward and back, upward, downward, sagittal plane movements, these lateral movements, you know, frontal plane, all that good stuff, you know, sidestepping, and then these transverse rotational movements like, you know, a punch, a kick, all that good stuff. So using the uneven weights helps you prepare. If you were actually if you were to lift an object that was uneven in the world, such as a couch, a log, you know, a lot of things that aren't in our gyms and aren't thought of by our traditional fitness industry, then you would notice very quickly within your body you're creating these torque patterns. You're pushing and pulling to stabilize, so that you don't fall over to one side or whatnot. So when you can actually bring awareness into the body, into the nervous system, you get to feel your whole body, wake your whole body up by just really being slow and controlled with all your movements, then you essentially begin to live this, you know, awakening of your very body, of your very sensual nature. So that's why I love training, and just very grateful to be back in it, in the flow of it, in the discipline of it, the devotion to it. So yeah, thank you guys for tuning in. I'm gonna do the rest of this and then we'll click it off and save it, share it. thanks guys for tuning in. I'm gonna peace out for now. I'm still gonna present that video about the immune system, our power as these self-healing organisms. You know, the many paths to that, it's not just one, though many people may think that, but you know, we all have our unique way to reclaim our health, radical responsibility for ourselves, our families, our communities, and ultimately the world. Ultimately, we're all in this together. No one is here to take away your freedom. You're the only one who can give your freedom away. So there's these subtleties, this tacit consent culture that we're born in, you know? But I'll get all into that in another video. I'm really grateful to just feel alive today in this movement, in this breath, in this life. So have a blessed one. Take care. Enjoy all the beauties of spring or, you know, winter, wherever you are. I got a nice cherry blossom right here. And yeah. Whoosh. Love, vision, and strength. Peace out, guys.